All right, it's time for our Friday evening summer song swap. All right. And you know everybody on this stage. They're all old friends of Falcon Ridge. So please welcome Mary Gauthier, Dan Navarro, Chris Matthews, and Greg Greenway. All right.
Thank you. And do we have any idea who's going to start?
We did the hard part.
Happy to go.
All right.
Go
right.
Come on, Goshen. Thanks.
Started with a song about a hobo named Steam Train. Elected king of the hobos at the annual hobo convention. Held every year for over 100 years in a town called Britt, Iowa. What a pleasure to be up here with my friends tonight. Steam Train Maury died last night. His wife wandered by his side. He caught the westbound out of here, hopped the high irons to the by and by. They say he jumped 10,000 trains and rode a million miles for free. Helped out at VA hospitals and penitentiaries. Dandy Dave, rusty nails, and sweet lady sugar cane. Deadeye Kate and the baloney kid raised their cups tonight in Steam Train's name. Senators and congressmen, puppets on a string. Among windswept vagabonds, Steam Train was king. He was the light. The hobo kings. He was the last of the hobo kings. Drink and wander round, tramps dream and wander too. But a hobo was a pioneer and he preferred to work for food. He knew how the nation was doing by the length of a sidewalk cigarette butt. Born with an aching wanderlust embedded in his gut. Hounded, beaten, laughed at, broke. Chased out of every town with his walking stick scepter, with his shredded coffee can crown, the last of the hobo kings. He was the last of the hobo kings. Mm-hmm. asked freemen or hobos. Steinbeck said and paid them cash. The stories he borrowed from them helped him write The Grapes of Wrath. But boxcars been sealed for years, and trespassers do time. Railroad yards are razor wire, now hoboing's a crime. So here's to you, Steam Train Maury. Hold that westbound tight as you ride off into history. The last hobo, the last ride, the last of the hobo kings. He was the last of the hobo. Thanks, Red.
Okay, solo.
I tune because I care. One of the things I love most about doing rounds is not only I get to hear and sing and play with people I love and have known for a long time, because everybody on the stage are people that I adore, but also you start thinking of what you might do. And I wasn't actually going to play this next song, because it stinks. No, I'm lying. But a fellow that I've been friends with for a long time out of Nashville named Charles John Quarto writes about hobos. He's a poet. He wrote Geronimo's Cadillac with and for Michael Martin Murphy. And I've been blessed to know him a long time. I'm just stalling while I tune. So I was in Nashville in 2003, and Charles John has never owned a car. So he traded us two lyrics for a ride home, including this one. If I was the rain, I'd polish every outbound train. I'd wipe the teardrops from your eyes so you could kiss the blues goodbye. If I was the rain, I'd answer all the farmers' prayers till green was growing everywhere. If I was the rain, I'd play the drums on every tin and roof from Shreveport to Baton Rouge, and let the songs make up themselves the way the best ones always seem to do. If I was the rain, I'd have no reason to explain. I'd fall between the fireflies. I'd never dampen any light. If I was the rain, I'd feed the rivers and the streams. I'd nourish every cowgirl's dreams. If I was the rain. Thank you. I'd strike a chord within each heart wherever they were torn apart. And if that helped them heal themselves, maybe we'd find out where forgiveness starts. If I was the rain, I'd choose forever to remain. I'd add a sparkle to the night and marvel at the morning bright. If I was the rain, I'd bless each blossom to unfold. I'd turn each one of them to gold. If I was the rain, if I was the rain, if I was the rain.
Thank you, everybody. That's a lyric by Charles John Quarto.
It is just such an honor to be up here with all these amazing folks. I think we're going to just start with the title track from my newest album. The song is called Changemakers. And if you know the words, I hope you'll sing with us. Sitting alone in this hotel room, TV on, tuned into the news. It's another day here in paradise. Mass shootings, deportations, wildfires. Meanwhile, Mr. Make America Great is busy tweeting his worst and spreading more hate. While some of us are so poor they can't afford shoes on their feet, while some other sweet baby starves to death in their sleep. Can you see us, we are dreamers? Can you feel us, we are believers? We are more than keyboard warriors. We are the change makers. Yes, we are. Yes, we are. Somewhere in 100 no-name towns are a million lives being turned upside down. And you know this is the only home those kids have ever known. Refugees from wars and regimes being overthrown. Meanwhile, too many of these United States ignore the words Lady Liberty spake. Doors being kicked down in the dead of the night. No more sanctuary cities. How's that for religious right? See us, we are dreamers. Can you feel us? We are believers. We are more than keyboard warriors. We are the change makers. Yes, we are. Yes, we are. And if there's anyone out there who questions what America at its very best will feel like now, remember 66 million, united in love, steadfastly indivisible across countless cities and towns. Oh, the bluest wave crashing from shore to shore. And all those hate has no home here. Signs on all those doors. We know who we are like we know how to breathe. Won't you sing it with me? Sing it with me, please. Give me your tired, your poor, your huddled masses yearning to breathe free. Give me the wretched refuse of your seeming shores and these, the homeless, the tempest tossed to me. Come on! Give me your tired, your poor, your huddled masses yearning to breathe free. Give me the wretched refuse of your seeming shores. us, we are dreamers. Can you feel us? We are believers. And we are more than keyboard warriors. We are the change makers. Yes, we are. Yes, we are.
Was that fantastic or what?
Yes. I met you in Washington, D.C. when you were like 2 feet tall.
That was awesome. Oh, man. Woo. Okay. So something crawled onto my voice. I have no idea why. But thank you for letting me go forth, because I've been over here singing, and I might be able to actually do something. So we'll work with what we have. So, thank you. And to follow that song, I want to say that in 2006, you know, the states started passing, you know, the Family Protection Act, you know. And so now these people must be delirious that these things are going the way they're going now. But this song I wrote back then, because it was as stupid then as it is now, is when they call my name, I'll be standing on the side of love. And that's what it's about. When they call my name, I'll be standing on the side of love. Oh. I used to stand by the side of a road that stretched into the past. I turned around, there were two ways to go, and a load to lay down at last. I saw sisters and daughters, brothers and sons. I saw the lines that divide them up. When they call my name, I'll be standing on the side of love. Now you can sing it and it won't sound so bad. When they call my name, I'll be standing on the side of love. Any help I can get from up here would be just awesome. Everybody knows history's a bald-faced lie. It all depends on the side you're from. There is no way to ever unwind all the things already done by sisters and daughters, brothers and sons, to push some down, to rise some up. Here it comes. When they call my name, I'll be standing on the side of love. Let's do it again. When they call my name, I'll be standing on the side of love. Now I wanna be there when the spaceship lands. Something crawls out that we don't understand. That's when we'll all embrace the family of man. And the rest will be forgotten with a little help from my friends. We the people, so many gave their lives to carry these words this far. We the people, there are times that it seems we've forgotten who the people are. They're just sisters and daughters, brothers and sons. No lines should divide them up. Here we go. When they call my name, I'll be standing on the sideline. When they call my name, I'll be standing on the side. Of sisters and daughters, brothers and sons, no lines shall divide us up. When they call my name, I'll be standing on the side of love. Everybody, when they call my name, on the side of love. All of you out there. One last time, slow. When they call my name, I'll be standing on the side of love. A little help from my friend. Not bad having like seven singers on the stage, you know?
So I'm a troubadour. Troubadouring, well, it's an approach, it's not a genre. Inside the word troubadour, I hear the word true. Troubadours, well, we tell stories true to feeling, not necessarily true to fact. People need stories to make meaning out of their lives, and songs are how most people get their stories. Modern-day troubadours are self-perceived outsiders who write songs about underdogs, unnoticed or marginalized folks, and struggles not often heard in mainstream music. In an age of misinformation, disinformation, and lies, we are the wandering minstrels who compose and perform songs to tell the damn truth. And like the stories of old, songs help teach us how to live. Troubadours, we play in theaters, listening rooms, and nightclubs, bars. We play in people's homes, yards. We play in barns. We play folk festivals. We play on live streams. We earn what we can, performing where we can. Troubadours are not the kind of songwriters who try to write songs for hit-driven marketplaces. We are the other kind.
That's right. No doubt about it.
When people ask what kind of songs I write, I tell them I write real ones. This confuses the shit out of people. See, I'm called to write songs that help folks check in, not check out. While my songs will likely not be hits, they feed me in ways that fame and money cannot. My work is more of a ministry than a show business venture, though there is, of course, a show business component in every successful ministry. I've played in dozens of countries. I've listened to thousands of people's stories. I've heard late-night confessions and held strangers in my arms as they wept. No matter a person's nationality, age, race, gender, sexuality, politics, religion, or lack thereof, humans are the same everywhere I go. So many people are lonely, yearning for meaningful connection. People everywhere need hope. We all need to believe in something. And people are hurting. Many are traumatized, afraid. People need love. But love is hard. It is so much harder than they expected. I understand, of course. I feel this way, too. It's why I became a troubadour. Well, Greg started the sing-along. This is a short one. It's 2 minutes and 6 seconds. I wrote this with a group of military spouses whose husbands were all bomb experts. They're called EOD warriors, and the EOD wives are kindred. I love them. Explosive ordnance disposal, EOD. Can you imagine being married to a bomb expert during a time of war? I asked them how they did it, and they said, here's how we do it, Mary. We do it together. we're stronger together. And this is the name of that song I'm about to sing and ask you to sing with me. I'll point when it's time. This is the EOD Wives' story. They say no man's left behind, but that ain't true. And they hate it that they need us, but they do. They lose their fingers, lose their limbs. We try to love them back together again. They say no man's left behind, but that ain't true. And they're hurt in places that the eye can't see. We miss the man our husbands used to be. The military breaks their heart. We're there when they fall apart. They're hurt in places that the eye can't see. And we're stronger together, sisters, forever. We are stronger together. Don't look like much, but we know it's a lot. Every time he says goodbye, could be the last time we see him alive. We focus on the good, that's all we've got. EOD wives don't sit by the phone. No news. It's good news back at home. When he's mission ready at his best, we take care of all the rest. EOD wives don't sit by the phone. And we're stronger together. Calling yourself a sister, but women have gotten mighty used to calling themselves part of mankind. So just for a chorus, would you be our sister, please? Stronger
sisters. badass. I take that storyteller role to heart. The other thing about troubadour is the first part of the word is trub. Oh. Now, I'm used to writing stories. But I wrote this song with someone named Jenny Yates. I had a chorus. She came over, and we chatted for 2 hours, and every word I said ended up in the damn verses. Be careful what you say around a songwriter. First to come and the last to go, right there in the thick of it, I wanna be in the know. Small, small talk, big, big deals, around the world, around the block on training wheels. I hope I don't miss it. I hope I don't stay too long. Hope I don't say something that I really mean that comes out wrong. I hope I don't lose it. Hope I get it before I'm gone. Hope that I'll know it when I find the place where I belong. Songs about songs, just shut up and sing. Say it how you mean it, and let that be the reasoning. Time moves on, and I'm waiting for the gong to get it up or get it out, if there's a point to it all. I hope I don't miss it. I hope I don't stay too long. Hope I don't say something that I really mean that comes out wrong. I hope I don't lose it. Hope I get it before I'm gone. Hope that I'll know it when I find the place where I belong. When I tried too hard, when I used my will, the hours passed like streetcars with yesterdays yet to fill. So I run this race, but it's all uphill. Maybe I can make it mine by standing still. Oh, I hope I don't miss it. I hope I don't stay too long. Hope I don't say something that I really mean that comes out wrong. Oh, I hope I don't lose it. Hope I get it before I'm gone. Hope that I'll know it when I find the place where I belong. I hope I don't miss it. I hope I don't stay too long. Hope I don't say something that I really mean that comes out wrong.
That's Radoslav Lorkovic.
I just want to sit and listen all night long. Well, this is I guess this one's kind of building off of twofold. This is a little bit of truth telling. in this next one here, and there's definitely a bit of, I hope I don't say it wrong. This next song is called Cancel Culture. And there's a lot of folks who are kind of saying things like, well, I'm just so scared to say anything, so I just won't say anything at all so that I don't get canceled. But that silence is what helps keep us complicit in a lot of instances. So, and there's plenty that we could be canceling. So this is a cancel culture. There's a part to sing at the very end. Just the words, drive out the darkness, that beautiful Dr. King quote. Darkness cannot drive out darkness, only light can do that. This is the time for so many of us to be shining our light so brightly.
There's a whole lot in our culture I'd cancel if I could. Instead of banning books, I'd ban gerrymandering for good. The rich would feed the poor like the good Lord said they should. And every child, without exception, would feel loved and understood. No more whitewashing our history when the truth will set us free. No more watching corporate profits soar while people sink into poverty. No more telling kids they're flawed because you think that your God would. There's a whole lot in our culture I'd cancel if I could. There's a whole lot in our culture we could cancel right away. Instead of banning saying gay, we should ban racist holidays. Teachers should get to teach without worrying about their pay, or if they'll have an active shooter that they'll have to keep at bay. No more kids in bulletproof backpacks. It's a school, not a war. No more pretending that machine guns are what the Second Amendment was for. No more doing nothing because it's easier most days. Yeah, there's a whole lot in our culture we should cancel right away. There's a whole lot in our culture we could cancel if we tried. Instead of banning abortions, we could trust women to decide. Every size and shape of body could be normalized, and every type of mental illness could finally be destigmatized. No more squeezing and contorting into boxes we don't fit. No more saying that we're fine when we're not, but scared to admit it. No more telling little boys it's better not to cry. There's a whole lot in our culture we could cancel if we tried. And we've been marching in these streets, singing we shall overcome, praying all the world would give up all their bombs and all their guns. I just want peace of every kind for the whole world tonight, and to believe that Martin was right. We can drive out the darkness with the light. Drive out the darkness.
Sing it.
Drive out the darkness. We can drive out the darkness with the light. Drive out the darkness. We can drive out the darkness with the light. Drive out the darkness. Drive out the darkness. We can drive out the darkness with the light.
Thank you so much, everybody.
See how we're doing now. This monitor over here. Let's see if I can pull this off. Well, you just.
Well, we got you. So we got everybody.
All right, all right. You know, because this just says, hate is too great a weight to bear. And that's another quote from Dr. King. Yep. So, thank you.
Yeah. We'll see how this goes. At the edge of Jericho Road, beneath
beneath the street lights, yellow, orange glow. The feared and the fallen go, in the way of predator and prey. No one's spared, 'cause hate is too great a weight to bear. In a cage of shadows we meet, naked, bloodied in the street. Not the mercy at the feet of the way of predator and prey. No one's spared, 'cause hate is too great a weight to bear. When the darkness unshattered pavement, the better rain shells fade, learning slumber, murder by numbers. Everyone holds some part of the truth. And now I'm in your way. Do we stay on Jericho Road, forever going nowhere, till hate is too great a weight to bear?
Been doing it every year for 32 years. It's always an honor to be up here with you, my friend. When we got the word that John Prine passed away, it felt to me like it was important to try to write something. He was my friend, but he was also my songwriting hero, and I loved him very, very much. And I just refused to believe that I won't see him again. So I wrote a song with my friend Ben Glover called "Till I See You Again," and we send it out to the spirit of John and to the spirit of our friend David Olney, and of course the spirit of our friend Nancy Griffith as well. It's been a rough go for a couple of years, losing my heroes and our heroes, and it's just the natural, I guess, way of things, but it feels like shit, and I miss them very, very much. My partner here, this is Jamie Harris.
the hollow of her hand. May a soft wind enfold you as you travel distant lands. May the moon and stars delight you as the daylight dims, till the morning sun warms your face, till I see you again. May you lay down your struggle beneath the silver sky. May a summer rain inside your dreams sing a lullaby. May there be no more struggle, no more pain. May you sleep inside the stillness of the night till I see you again.
A little knob got turned down. I have a new record that I brought with me. It's this is actually the first place it's for sale anywhere on the planet. It's called Horizon Line. I'll be playing songs from it tomorrow on main stage. But I was talking to Mary and Jamie about how there are actually some happy songs on it for a change. And the thing is that it reflects a new point of view that I've got these days. This song is not one of those. This song was inspired by events that took place at the Woody Guthrie Festival in 2015. I fell in love. And like some things do, it kind of went off into the ditch. The person who inspired this song shall remain nameless so as not to embarrass her family, Mr. and Mrs. Thomas Cady of Stockton, California.
I found an angel heart under Oklahoma skies, wrapped in a melody gentle as the night. It was the purest sound that I had ever known. Then it was gone into a song I'll never know. I felt the sweetest words a heart could ever give, reach deep inside of me before they disappear. And as I held them close, I had to let them go without a trace into a place I'll never know. Now I'll try to understand. Understanding comes so slow. I am a simple man, holding steady as she goes. Understanding comes so slow. I am a simple man, holding steady as she goes. And as the colors turn to signal summer's end, I see the angel heart riding restless as the wind, as she returns again. So ever will she go into the mist, but more than this I'll never know. And there remains a sweet refrain I'll never know. I found an angel heart under Oklahoma skies.
Radoslav Lorkovic.
So Heather and I were cracking up as soon as Dan started queuing that one up, because I already had the guitar tuned to sing this beautiful song called Oklahoma Sunset.
Wait for it.
Let me just say also, if you have not been to the Woody Guthrie Festival, you've got a 50-50 shot of falling in love or falling out. This song was about falling in love.
And was inspired by an Oklahoma sunset that we saw at the Woody Guthrie Festival.
Literally last year.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I hope you really love Oklahoma.
There we go.
And I will also introduce my lovely partner on and off stage. This is the wonderfully talented Heather May.
Yeah.
in July, Friday night, side by side, your hand in mine, just carrying on like we do. I couldn't take my eyes off of you. She's beautiful. If I'm watching or not, if I do or don't say, even when the storm is rolling, it doesn't stop her light from shining. She's an Oklahoma sunset on a summer night. Stop dead in my tracks just to bask in her light. Oh, she keeps me breathless. Her glory is endless. I hope her light never fades. Well, she's how I wanna end every day. When I come home from a long day, the sight of her takes it all away. Just sitting on the back porch, taking her in, is enough to ease all my worrying. She's got a warmth about her that soothes me. A glow all around her that moves me, even when the storm is rolling in. It doesn't stop her light from shining. She's an Oklahoma sunset on a summer night. Stop dead in my tracks just to bask in her light. Oh, she keeps me breathless. Her glory is endless. I hope her light never fades. Oh, she's how I wanna end every day. The twilight blue in the sky, until the pink is her cheeks on those red hot nights. But my favorite part is her golden heart.
You know, sing to me.
Mm-hmm. Well, she's an Oklahoma sunset on a summer night. Stop dead in my tracks just to bask in her light. Oh, she keeps me breathless. Her glory is endless. I hope her light never fades. Oh, she's how I wanna end every day. I wanna end every day this way.
Thanks so much.
I hope you all will help me again. This is probably the second song I wrote as a songwriter. And it's amazing that it comes from a painting that comes from a myth. And the myth you all know of wax wings and feathers and flying too close to the Oklahoma sun. That's right. Dudless worked in Tulsa, and his son just wanted to get out, you know? And so they made the wax wings, and they Dudless made it out. Well, he made it to the panhandle, but Icarus just crashed right in. Is there a lake in Oklahoma somewhere? Yeah, a lake in Oklahoma, yeah.
We never left Okeewa.
There we go. He fell in that. And it was really sad for a long time. So it inspired me in my trip through Oklahoma. And I sang this song, and it starts with me, but it gets to the myth, just about crossing the Mississippi, I think. And maybe you will sing this with me, because when Icarus fell into the lake, kind of everybody in Oklahoma didn't notice. They were too busy. It was the state was playing Oklahoma that weekend. All right, I'm sorry, I'm keeping you all up. All right. So the chorus just goes like this. Sun goes up, moon goes down, and you knew from the start the measure of all things is still the heart. That's it. Sun goes up, moon goes down, and you knew from the start the measure of all things is still love. And there's a cello solo in there for you, Vlad. So, and third verse will be all yours, okay? And the sun came up down an old dirt road, saying, hello, new day, hello. It shone on my back like a father's hand, saying, my son, how you have grown. Sun goes up, moon goes down, and you knew from the start the measure of all things still the heart. Oh, please come and stand at the microphones. At least visually assist me. Sun goes up, moon goes down, and you knew from the start the measure of all things is still the heart. Yeah. And the bum lay down in a rain-wet street, saying, I don't care, I don't care. I'm far too deep in this cold, dark well of things that keep me here. Sun goes up, moon goes down, and you knew from the start the measure of all things is still
now. Let's hear the man play. Sun goes up, moon goes down, and you knew from the start the measure of all things is still the heart. And on wings of wax he flew too high, till he fell into the sea. And the ship sailed on, and the farmer plowed, and the day passed gracefully. Sun goes up, moon goes down, and you're blue from the start. The measure of all things is still the Lord. Sun goes up, moon goes down, and you're blue from the start. The measure of all things is still the Lord.
Thank you, my friend.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.
Thanks so much, everybody.
Mary Gauthier and Jamie Harris. Greg Greenaway. Chris Matthews and Heather May. I'm Dan Navarro.
Dan Navarro.
This is Radoslav Lorkovic.
All right, that's our show for tonight. Thanks for hanging out with us on this Friday night. We're back at the main stage at 11 tomorrow morning, so we'll see you then.